Hi everyone, we'll continue with the topic refrigeration. So already we have seen the properties and different types of refrigerants. So now we'll see the classification of refrigeration system. Refrigeration systems are classified into mainly two types. One is air refrigeration system, second one is vapor refrigeration system. So air refrigeration system uses air as a refrigerant. In vapor refrigeration system, refrigerants like Freon 12, Freon 22, ammonia, methyl chloride, etc. are used as a refrigerants. 1 to 2, what it is having? Isothermal expansion. 1 to 2, adiabatic compression. 2 to 3, isothermal compression. And 3 to 4, adiabatic expansion. And 4 to 1 is isothermal expansion. So here, this is the TS diagram, standard square. It will be square. So 1 to 2, which process? Adiabatic compression to adiabatic and to isothermal process it is having in the cycle. So adiabatic compression, the working fluid with the aid of external work temperature, fluid rises from T2 to T1. So in this isothermal compression, what happens? Working fluid during which heat is rejected at constant high temperature, that is T1. So right, similarly adiabatic expansion and isothermal expansion. So now we'll go for efficiency, this one calculation, not efficiency, since it is refrigeration. Again I will say it is a coefficient of performance. So heat absorbed is at Q2, T2 into dS, and heat rejected is Q1, T1 into dS. Means TdS we have studied in the entropy chapter, that is BTD. So what is work input or W net? Heat rejected minus heat absorbed. But in the engine, what it is? Heat absorbed or heat supplied minus rejected. Just opposite. In the first video, first definition only I said, if you reverse the heat engine, it is refrigerant, a refrigerator and heat pump. Now it is, we have reversed, heat rejected minus heat absorbed, right? So there what we have seen in the efficiency, W net divided by QS, but here reverse it, QR by W net. That also it will see, we will see this here. So Q1 minus Q2, Q1 minus Q2 expressions we are having here, T1 minus T2, TdS, dS it will come. So cooling effect is Q2, Q2 is heat absorbed divided by Q1 minus Q2. So substitute the values of this formula and at last we will get the formula as this one. So dS I can expand again, SB minus SBA, SB minus SA here also, because it is a rectangle. So this will get cancelled, we will get the final expression as T2 divided by T1 minus T2. So what we were getting in the this one, efficiency calculation, 1 minus T1 by T2 we were getting in the efficiency calculation. But here what we will get? T2 divided by T1 minus 1. So just opposite of that. Right, we'll go first. Reversed air refrigeration cycle or Bell-Coleman cycle. So what it is having, you just see here. In this heat exchanger will be there, compressor, heat exchanger and turbine. So heat exchanger from cold region to, it is going to suck in the heat. Here it is going to supply the heat to the warm region, right? So this is TH and this is TC, because TC for cold and H for hot. So this is the PV diagram. What it is having? PV diagram, 1 to 2 again both are isentropic compression as it is in Carnot cycle. 2 to 3 there it was isothermal, here it is constant pressure. Here again 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and 4 to 1 again it is constant pressure. So this is the PV diagram, TS diagram we are going to get here. So here S1 is equal to S2 and S3 is equal to S4, because this is a straight line. Now we'll go for calculating coefficient of discharge. See here, whatever is the refrigeration or heat pump or a heat engine, the PV raised to gamma for isentropic compression remains same. Here P is constant, here also P is constant, here also PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, or TV raised to gamma minus 1 is also constant in this, right? Next we'll go for derivation. First we'll explain. In a reverse Breton refrigeration cycle, the working fluid remains as a gas, that is air, throughout. The Breton refrigeration cycle is reversed of a Breton power. That Bell-Coulombs cycle is also known as reverse Breton cycle here, right? So here also same thing, 1 to 2 same process whatever I have explained here. These things only they have written, process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 5. So heat rejected during 2 to 3, just heat rejected during 2 to 3, you just see in the TS diagram only you see CP. Why CP? Constant pressure. 2 to 3 is constant pressure. So CP into T2 minus T1. M we have neglected because assuming 1 kg. And QA is equal to CP into T1 minus T4. So work done by the is given by QR minus QA. You remember this. QA minus QR is in heat engine. QR minus QA is in refrigerator. So this is the final expression we have got. But what we know about COP? Heat absorbed divided by total work done. So QA we know the here from this equation, QA is here and W is here. Substitute these both equations in this equation and I will get this equation. So CP gets cancelled and in terms of temperature only this will be in the this form. Now just resolve for this for perfect cooling, because it is a refrigeration, T1 must be equal to T3 because it should cool there in the refrigeration. So then you substitute wherever T1 is there, you substitute T3. So T3 minus T4 is here also and here also. So this what you will write, this one T3 minus T4 you will be writing in this fashion, and he is going to invert it. In one step you can add here how you can write T3 minus T4 divided by T2 minus T3 minus 1, because 1 T3 minus T4 and T3 minus T4 get cancelled, and he want to take it reverse way. So 1 divided by everything, or numerator is transferred to denominator and denominator transferred to numerator, and you just divide by 1. So this will be, because T2 by T3 is coming up and T4 by T3 minus T4 is going down, so that we are getting dividation here. So from this what you will do, take out the T3 from this T2 minus T3, you take out the common term as T3, and from here T4 you take it as a common. So if you take T3, T2 by T3, again T3 if we substitute it, nothing will harm here. T4 is taken in this fashion. So next. So we know that isentropic compression is what? T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is also one TP relation it is. So P2 by P1 is RP, pressure ratio. Pressure raised to gamma minus 1. So similarly this one also, what process 3 to 4, here also you will get RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So when these two are equal, T2 by T1 and T3 by T4 are also equal. So T2 by T1 is equal to T3 by T4. I can just make a mathematical modification, and I can T3 I can take this side, T4 T1 I can take this side. So T2 by T3 is equal to, here it is T1, sorry, he has mistakenly he has written like this, so we'll just change here. So this is T1, here it is T1, so T1 by T4. So you got that. So T3 by T4 will get cancelled, and in that earlier equation you substitute this equation, and you will get at the end, you will get this in this form. You are going to just modify the equation, T4 divided by T3 minus T4. So this equation again I can write T3 by T4 is equal to what here? RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this is the final equation, 1 divided by RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So this is how this is the final COP of this one, Bell-Coulombs refrigeration cycle. So next we'll continue the next portion in the next video. Thank you.